obtained an associate's in physical therapy assistant in the year 2011. My father was born in Zaragoza, Coahuila, Mexico, and my mother was born in Eagle Pass, Texas. My father went to elementary school up until he was 8 years old in Zaragoza, Coahuila. From 8 years old all through high school, he went to school here. I know that he went to Fox Tech High School, where he dropped out in the 12th grade. He decided to go back and get his GED because in the field that he works in, he does security systems. He needed to be licensed under certain things, so that required for him to go back and get his GED. And my mother went to middle school most of the years here in San Antonio and then moved back to Mexico. And she did not continue her education over there. I was always very interested in school because of what my mother used to always tell me, which is she used to always be very upset that she wasn't able to continue in school. And she feels like she didn't get to do anything for herself. So she would always motivate me as far as going to school and getting an education and becoming something of myself. Growing up in a bicultural, bilingual world, maybe just in elementary, I had some difficulty because I was actually, up until the first grade, was in an ESL class. So reading was very difficult for me because at home, all we spoke was Spanish. During high school, I feel like I didn't have a whole lot of support from my teachers and administration. I went a couple of times to my counselor to ask about dual credit or, you know, what else can I take? I want to take advanced math. And it was always like the reactions I would get was, why do you want to do that? And I would always say, well, I want to continue going to school. It's not going to stop here. I decided I wanted to go into physical therapy my senior year of high school. They had this program where it was called Health Careers. And for two periods of the day, we would go to Southwest General Hospital and just volunteer. I think what I really enjoyed about it was after going for so long, you would see the patient's progress and you would see how happy it would make them and how rewarding it was. So that was very interesting to me. College was a little bit more difficult trying to find a balance between family, work, and school. Sometimes I would get questions from family like, you know, why aren't you coming to this party, or why do you leave so early, or why aren't you around as much? Just because we're so used to doing everything together as a family. And of course, we love to party. So there was times where I would either not go or leave early because I had to study. Finding the time to do studying between work and family was a little difficult. Once it got to the point where they realized, oh, she's pretty serious about going to school, they kind of backed off and were more supportive than questioning why. I think the biggest struggle I had while I was in college was once I was in the PTA program. My first year, I actually failed out of a class. They only gave you one class that you could fail out of, and you had to wait the entire year until that class was offered again to continue into the program. When I failed out of the class, it was a very big eye-opener. But I think that was very scary, thinking, this is what I want to do, and I'm not going to get the chance to do it if I don't really sit and focus and do what I need to do to complete this class and pass it. I was very fortunate to have my parents there to give me the opportunity to not work full-time and go to school. And then the following year, I was back into the same class and I continued there. Looking forward, I really enjoy what I'm doing now as a director of rehab because it's a lot more of like the business aspect, but I also get the opportunity to continue treating the patients. Hopefully in the future, once I gain more experience and learn a whole lot more, I would like to be considered for a regional director position. The only advice I have for anyone else that's interested in going to college or furthering their education would be just to look for help. If you ask questions, there's always going to be help, not only financially, but there's always support. There's always people that want to help. Sometimes you have to go out and look for it yourself, but it's out there.
I received my bachelor's degree in 2008 in political science, and I minored in legal studies. My dad was born in Durango, Mexico, and my mother was born also in Mexico, in Coahuila. And my mother came to America when she was still in elementary school, and my father came when he was in his teens. My mother obtained some college, and then she had to drop out in order to help with finances at her home. It was two brothers and two sisters. And my dad, he only obtained an elementary school education, I believe up to second grade. And he was forced also to work and be able to provide for his family in Mexico. As a child, I didn't really have trouble growing up in a bicultural, bilingual world. My parents taught me to speak Spanish, and I learned English in school, so it wasn't something that I struggled with. In high school, I think what's worth noting is I didn't feel like I was singled for my ethnicity or my background, because in high school, you know, it was very normal to hear in the hallways people speaking Spanish as opposed to English. It was very accepted. I know in soccer, we had our chants, and instead of them being in English, they were in Spanish. Even people who didn't really know Spanish were, you know, chanting along. So it was something where it really felt like my high school was a family, and, you know, we all kind of fit in. Growing up, my dad wasn't as involved. He was more of the breadwinner. He was, you know, always working, and, you know, that was more the role he played, but he made sure that I had what I needed in order to go to school. And my mom, she was more hands-on. She was the one who would take me by the hand to school. She would pick me up. Even in my undergrad years, you know, there were times where I couldn't drive, or, you know, for whatever reason I was running late, and she'd bring me to school. And I've always said that I obtained my bachelor's, but that's not only mine, it's also my family's, because they were there every step of the way. I know when I was up till 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, they were also up. You know, they were worrying about me. You know, they would bring me food. They would make sure that I was okay. So they were involved, and they were very encouraging. They knew that I liked school. I never doubted that I wanted to go to college. I saw my parents struggle with the little education they had. I saw that they had to work extra hard. I saw that with my grandfather as well. And they also stressed that they want me to work smart, not hard. So it was expected that I was going to go to college. And I took that upon myself. I saw that seeing them struggle, seeing the sacrifices they made, it was my duty to also put my end of the bargain and go to college, not only for myself, but for them. Some of the struggles I had as a student was, for one, we didn't have that much money, so I had to find a job and juggle that, you know, be able to manage my time and be disciplined as well with my studies. The other struggle I also had that I think was much greater and that I'm still dealing with today is loosening those family ties. I was given some opportunities where I could have gone, you know, to Austin and do an internship. But again, you know, those really close family ties that I have, you know, I was just scared to not break them, but kind of loosen them up to get out of that comfort zone. And as far as managing my time, you know, I know juggling a job and, you know, the academics, sometimes I would feel like I was on the short end. But in the end, it was all worth it. I learned a lot about myself. Now what I am doing is I actually moved about 5 hours away from San Antonio, so I'm breaking out of my nest. And I am searching for a job. I'm looking for a career. I had been accepted to law school, but it did not work out. I learned that the legal route was not my career path. And currently, I'm just trying to find myself, really trying to define who I am. I'm keeping my options open. I'm considering going to graduate school, or if not, you know, finding a career where I can help others. Looking back from my college experience and being now a college graduate, I feel a sense of pride. I am happy and proud that I worked hard and I was able to get a degree, and I was able to show that it's possible, you know, living in a Mexican-American household, you know, it's possible, you know, don't let money be an issue. You know, things that come as struggles can always be dealt with and be turned around and turned into positives. And you never should close a book on education because it's something that cannot be taken away. And that's something that I was always taught, and that's something that I really firmly believe in.
I have my Associates of Photography from San Antonio College. I have my Bachelor's of Art and my Master's from the University of Texas at San Antonio. My mother only went to sixth grade. She was born in San Luis Potosí in Mexico, and she wasn't able to pursue any other education because since she was one of the older siblings from 15, she had to provide for the younger ones. Education was still high on her ideology, and she wanted to make sure that her children had it. My father is from San Antonio, Texas. He grew up on the west side. My father, unfortunately, he had to drop out of high school. He started going back to school in the late 80s, early 90s, pursuing his associate's degree. He finally graduated with his associate's in May of 2014, of this year, and now is pursuing his bachelor's degree. Growing up with one immigrant parent, I could say I had a very unique upbringing. Even within my family, one side of my family, very Mexicanos, very, very traditional. And the other side, very Tex-Mex. I wouldn't say too Mexicano, but not too American, but very, the beliefs of American ideologies were very high. It was weird. I feel like I had to balance myself in two worlds. It was fun sometimes. And I had a, you know, one day speak in Spanish, the other day speak in English. I liked it. I like growing up in a bicultural background. Now, having said that, during going through my school life, it wasn't as fun. I grew up in public and private schools. I can remember some instances where I didn't feel accepted. I was not so wealthy. I ended up going to these schools because I had gotten scholarships. Although we all had the same beliefs in God and ideologies, I do remember feeling secluded. I do remember like, oh, the Mexicans were here and the whites were here. I do remember at this particular Christian school, very few teachers were there to help me. It was the year 1999, I found out my mom was pregnant with my brother. My mom had told us that we were no longer going to attend private school, that we were going to go into public school. There was kind of fear because I didn't know anything else. If anybody can tell you that's grown up in a private school, it's very sheltered, it's very close-minded. You didn't know there's another world out there. I remember going into my first public school in eighth grade. Although it was still in the north side, I still felt fear. I all these stereotypes of gangs or somebody was gonna hurt me came to me. I was very fearful of that. And things were very different. There were other cultures in there. At first I was fearful, but once I got into school, I made friends right away. And they helped me transition beautifully, and I had so much fun. I thank my parents to say thank you for sending me to a public school, because it was a great opportunity for me to see other things than what I had seen. I don't know if I had the support of going into college. I remember talking to my counselor. I wanted to go to college. I knew I was going to go to college. I know my mom would kill me if I went. But she didn't really give me other options than to stay in San Antonio. She believed I should just stay in San Antonio. And she picked UTSA. And although I did want to go outside, I never thought I could, because, you know, I feel like, well, maybe the counselor's right. Maybe I should stay in San Antonio. Getting my undergraduate degree right off of high school, going into the University of Texas, San Antonio, had many struggles with it. Struggles as completing the assignments, how to deal with professors, how to talk to them. Once I completed my basics and was able to go into the history department, I had other struggles that I had to deal with. I didn't feel like I felt it fit in the department, and I was very close to my advisor at the time. I told her that I I didn't know what to do. I wanted to pursue my passion in art, but she advised me to go to San Antonio College because San Antonio College had a great photography program. Once I came back to UTSA, talked to my advisor, she helped me transfer to the art department here. But with that came many struggles. I felt the professors weren't accepting my art. At this point, I was doing photography and drawings. There were times I would do something what I thought was prevalent to me and my culture. At the time as well, I had minored in bilingual bicultural studies. There, I met the most incredible professors in my life who I'm friends with today. I really loved the department. I ended up doing my master's in bilingual bicultural studies. I've never felt very accepted. My work was completely accepted. My research was accepted. Everything I've done or have done in these last 2 years while working with my master's degree has been a complete success. I have no bad stories. I have nothing to say bad about the department. They continue to work with me with my research, and they continue to push me to pursue a PhD. As a recent graduate, I have looked into pursuing my postdoctorate degree. I'm actually in the process of doing the paperwork and everything I need to do that. I also love to mentor children because of all the struggles I've had. I thought it was very important that I needed to give back to the community. I think we as a society need to give the future children chances, and we need to be role models and leaders and mentors to them so our community can grow and they will be as or more successful than we wherever would be. But the fact that we had that place in their life and or had that hand in their life, that they were able to move on to the next level.